In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and for all ages, of all ages, Amen. The chapter from the Holy Gospel is a part from the events which took place before the birth of our Lord. It tells us about the Annunciation, the proclamation of the coming of the Savior to Saint Mary. The Annunciation. An angel appeared to a teenaged girl and gave her unusual greetings. Rejoice, O full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. Rejoice, O full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. An awesome and unusual encounter between the two heavens. The heaven itself, represented by an angel, and Saint Mary, who became the second heaven because the Son of God dwelt inside her. Unusual encounter, a very serious event to take place, impossible things will happen, and she was chosen to be part of it. And the angel revealed to Saint Mary God's plan for salvation through the mystery of incarnation. He chose her, the Lord God chose her, to be the mother of his Son, to give him birth to the Lord Jesus, who will be great, the Son of the Highest, and will reign forever, and of his kingdom there shall not be an end. Then Saint Mary asked the angel a question: how it comes? How? Not because unbelief, no, but because she felt that who is she to be the mother of the Most High? It was out of humility and of denying herself. And also she just wanted to know how. This is something impossible. Never happened and never will happen again. And the angel explained to her and referred to her what happened to Elizabeth, her relative. And he assured her that with God, nothing is impossible. With God, nothing is impossible. So he revealed to her God's call, and then we see her response. God's call. God's call for Saint Mary to be the mother of the Savior and to be sanctified. The Holy Spirit will come upon you and the power of the Highest will overshadow you to prepare you to be ready to carry inside you the Son of God, to serve as the mother of the Most, of the Son of the Most High, and accompanied that also to suffer. Accepting means suffering in this situation, to participate in the sufferings. As Simeon the elder told Saint Mary when she went to the temple after 40 days of the birth, he told her that a sword will pierce through your heart. A sword will pierce through your own soul. Sword of pain and sharing the suffering of her son. So it was an extraordinary call, great honor, but in the same time, a high price. She knew it, but she said yes, 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 and amen. Then Mary said to the angel, "Behold, the maid servant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your way. Here I am, O Lord." Her answer was yes. It means full submission. Also reveals that she was really full of grace, and the grace of God worked in her and gave her favor before the Lord. The grace of God was operative in Saint Mary, preparing her to be a good tool in the hands of the Lord to do the impossible. Saint Mary's yes reveals very important virtues in her. It reveals her availability, reveals her identity, her receptivity, and her conformity. First, her availability. "Behold, the maid servant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." Behold, here I am in your service, in your service. No reservations, no exceptions, no buts. "Lord, I'll do this and that, but I cannot do this and that." No, here I am. Like what happened with Isaiah, the prophet, when he saw his vision and he heard the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Who shall I send and who will go for us?" And the answer came from Isaiah, "Here am I, send me. Here am I, send me." She felt from herself that she cannot do it, but through God's grace, she can. The Lord gives his treasures in earthen vessels, as St. Paul tells us. We have this treasure, the treasures of God's grace, in earthen vessels. He is looking for availability, not for ability. If we look at our abilities and what we can do, this will be in the way of God's work in our life. But when we deny ourselves and submit to him, he will do by us and through us the impossible. Her availability, then her identity. How she identified herself? The maid servant of the Lord. The angel was telling her awesome things. The power of the Most Highest will overshadow you. The Holy Spirit will descend upon you. You will be the mother of the Son of the Most High. And then what was her response? "Behold, the maid servant of the Lord." St. Paul also, in many of his epistles, he started by this: Paul, a bond servant of Jesus Christ. Saint Paul did not only consider himself a bond servant of the Lord, but he considered himself even a bond servant to those whom he served, telling them that we do not preach ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your bond servants. The Lord himself said so. The Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to offer himself a ransom for many. Then Saint Mary receptivity. She was good receiver to God's grace. No obstacles on the way. When we submit to God, his grace will work in us. Then it will not be us, but his grace in us. As Saint Paul tells us, by the grace of God, I am who I am. By the grace of God, I am who I am. And his grace toward me was not in vain. The grace of God which with me. The key here is the grace of God. Then Saint Mary conformity. A good tool, a flexible tool in the hands of the Lord to do the impossible by her. Let it be to me according to your word. God has a plan and a purpose for each one of us. Are we submitting and conforming to his plan, or we are on the way of God's plan? Do we mean it when we say in the Lord's Prayer, your will be done, or your will be done, but except this and that? In this way, God's grace will not work in us. When we submit, he will work in us to follow his will and to do what pleases him. God's call for us. We knew about his call to Saint Mary and her response. How about us? God has a call for each person of us. A call for salvation, for sanctification, for service, and for suffering. First, for salvation. God has no pleasure in the destruction of the sinner, but rather to return and live. Salvation is offered, granted, and guaranteed to whoever accepts salvation. Second, sanctification. This is the will of God, our sanctification. Who wanted us to be saints, sanctified through the works of the Holy Spirit. Then service. Are we available to serve the Lord? Here am I, O Lord, a bond servant for you. Or our ego in the way. We don't want to serve. We don't want to be offering ourselves. We don't want to offer ourselves at the feet of the Lord. You may ask, what should I do? You know what to do. God equips each person of us with certain talents and gifts. With those talents and gifts, we should offer acceptable service to the Lord. Then suffering. Oh, this is a hard thing. We incline toward relaxing, pleasure, enjoyment. But how about suffering? You know what? The bad news is, suffering is the portion and the lot of each person in this world since the fall. No exception. So we are fortunate to suffer for the Lord. As long as we will suffer anyway, why don't we take it in a good way and take it as participation in the suffering of the Lord? And if we suffer with him, we will be glorified with him. If we want the Lord to do the impossible through us and in us, the key is to say yes and amen. Yes, O Lord, here I am, your bond servant. You all hear about the Salvation Army, special during Christmas time. You find those standing in front of the shopping with a bill and a bucket to collect donations. The one who established this service, his name, William Booth. William Booth lived between 1829 and 1912. And he is the one who established this ministry in London to serve the poor kids of London, to collect them from the streets and offer them place to stay in and offer them food and clothes. And it was a very successful ministry, and it went on till nowadays, and very successful ministry. Once a certain famous preacher visited William Booth, and he asked him a question. What is the secret behind your success in your ministry? What is the secret behind this success? When he asked him this question, he found tears flowing from his eyes, covering his cheeks. And he told him this answer. The secret is, when I started this ministry, God has had all there was of me. God has had all what was in me. There have been men with greater brains than I, men with greater opportunities. But from the day I got the poor of London on my heart and a vision of what Jesus Christ could do with the poor of London, I made up my mind that God could have all of William Booth there was. This is the mystery. This is the key. When God had all of William Booth, he did wonders through him and still doing a lot of good deeds through his ministry. If we want God to do the impossible with us and through us, we have to say yes. Here I am, O Lord, your bond servant. The call for Saint Mary to be the mother of the Savior, to be sanctified, to serve, to suffer. Her answer was yes. Behold the maid servant of the Lord. His call for each one of us, a call for salvation, for sanctification, for service and suffering. What is our answer? You think about it and submit it to the Lord, and glory be to God forever. Amen.